Are you serious? Are you serious? The Las Vegas security guard that was shot, we found out he's not even registered in the state of Nevada to be a security guard. What? I mean, the story keeps changing, guys. First of all, he was made to be the hero. We were told he was shot after Stephen Paddock apparently was shooting from the 32nd floor window of the Mandalay Bay Resort and Casino. And that he kind of, by getting in the hallway there, that he's the reason that Paddock shot him and then stopped shooting and realized that the authorities were on their way and then supposedly took his own life. We find out later by listening to the 911 tapes that that's not true at all. That he actually the Las Vegas security guard, based on cameras and audio tape from 911, was shot, according to the time on the 911 call-in, when he called in to say, I've been shot, was before 10 minutes of hell rained down on the country music fans at the listening to Country Music Entertainer of the Year, Jason Aldean, on stage. Jason Aldean. So what do you, what? If think about this. If Stephen Paddock is the shooter, and I'm still starting to wonder if he was even the shooter. If he was, and he shot the security guard first, then it would alert everybody that there's a guy on the 32nd floor who has just shot a security guard. You wouldn't shoot the security guard first and then shoot the people. So because the security guard was shot first, who actually shot him? And so now, and then what about the videotape that show rapid fire coming off the fourth floor? And I've seen three different videotapes that show that. And what about the videotape that shows a guy standing on the ground in the crowd, who then hunches down and sets up in a shooting position to fire? Well, and then you can hear the sound. I can't see the gun, but I can hear the shooting in the distance from what would be the 32nd floor. But then I can hear his rat-tat-tat-tat right there next to the guy who had a camera behind him. So it's as if there was at least three shooters. And anyway, I don't think one guy could shoot out of those two different windows. I think there had to be at least two up there shooting on the 32nd floor, one person shooting on the fourth floor, and at least one shooting in the crowd, if not more, because there's eyewitnesses who say they had seen people shooting people in the crowd. Now, I understand in the midst of the confusion with 22,000 people and what have you, that there can be confusion, but the timeline, how do you say the guy had already been shooting and then you're shot? But then we listen to that. That's what the security guard said. He heard all this shooting and then he was shot. But when we get the 911 tapes, it's clear he is shot first before and calling in 911 before there's ever a shot ringing from the Mandalay Bay Resort and Casino. So having said that, we've got to, and then we find out the security guard, the hero, Jesus Campos, is not even registered in the state of Nevada to be a security guard. So was he brought in to participate? Also, we find out that Stephen Paddock's house had been broken into. Now, that's going to tamper with the evidence. Can you believe that? Folks, there's just... And then you've got the sheriff. Sheriff Joseph Lombardo, who says, guys, it's not adding up. And oh, by the way, how in the world did Stephen Paddock get 23 guns and thousands of rounds of ammunition up to the 32nd floor and nobody saw it? You know how many cameras are in that casino? Do you realize how much security there is in Vegas? There's cameras everywhere because they're concerned about the cash that flows through these places. There's just no way. This is not adding up, folks. And the questions are getting more and the answers are getting far-fetched and less. I'm telling you, this looks like a staged event. The people were really shot. I'm not talking about that they weren't shot. They were shot. They are dead. They're burying people's family members. That's not a question. Question is, how many people was actually shooting? And what was the motivation behind it? Do we, I mean, are we talking about trying to take the guns from the American people? Was this also, and what about the timing of this? During the same time that the national anthem about the flag, trying to tear down America's spirit in its national pride, the same time you're trying to confiscate our guns from a shooting situation. It's the timing. Are you serious? I'm going to leave this with you. Somebody help me understand it. I'm just being honest. I'm not even being a conspiracy theorist here. I'm just asking questions. Are you serious? This stuff's not adding up. Pray for America. Pray for the families of the 59 people that are dead. Please pray for their families of the victims. Pray for the hundreds that were shot for healing and full recovery, and the thousands that have been traumatized. Are you serious? Pray.